Hello and welcome to this video tutorial from Computergaga.com. In this video, we're going to look at how to create a scrolling news ticker loop effect for your PowerPoint presentations. And in my example here, I am going to deliver a workshop on Excel tips and tricks. I have this introduction presentation, and I want one of these looping news tickers at the bottom to tease my delegates with the amazing tips that are to come. So what I've done ahead of this video is simply inserted a shape and kind of hidden the border and made it a light shade of blue, and I've inserted a separate text box. So that text is not on the shape, it is a separate text box that I've written in, made it a size 28 font, and I've centered it over that blue shape, which is going to be the kind of breaking news banner at the bottom. So now we need the animation effects to make that scroll and loop around there continuously while my delegates arrive for the workshop. So let's begin by selecting my text box and in the animations tab apply a flying effect and tell it to happen from the right hand side, which is typically how these news tickers would work. Now that was very, very fast in that preview. You saw how that kind of shot in. So I guess my next job is to slow it down with the duration setting on the far right hand of the animations tab. Now I'm going to increase that quite a lot because that was extremely fast. I could type in there rather than stabbing at this spinner box arrow, but I'm going to go up to 10 seconds. Now let's look at what this looks like at the moment. If I go to my slideshow and decide to play this, let's just get that animation to happen with previous rather than on the click of my button. And this is what it looks like. I have this news ticker coming along nice and slow. I think that's a good pace so people can read that. And then it stops when it gets to the end and stays on screen. So a couple of things. We need that to come off the screen and to keep scrolling. And we need it to loop so it comes back round again and again. So let's come out of this slideshow. And first of all, let's look at dealing with the fact that it needs to come off my slide. I'm going to zoom out. It's a lot easier to do if I zoom out of this slide. And I'll drag that text box away and off that slide deck. So it doesn't stop on the slide deck. It moves through and past that slide. There we go. That will handle that particular issue. Now I need it to continuously loop throughout the life of this slide, this title slide, until I move on to the next one. So on my animations tab for this text box, I'm going to bring up the animation pane. Makes it a lot easier to deal with these animations. And I want to get into the timing options, some of the animation effect options. In timing, we have a setting to repeat, or shall we say loop this, until the end of this slide, just this slide. See, I can specify a number of occurrences, and that kind of stuff can be handy also. I'm going to say the end of the slide and click OK. And you see a little preview of it coming across there. That would come through and out the other side. So the user won't see it come out the other side because of the slide. And that would keep doing that for the eternity of the slide. So we've got that working. But if we look at it in a like real-time environment at the moment, it does go through. Now it will loop. But I need another one to quickly follow after that. However, it has to come all the way through until it begins again. Now that's quite a nice news ticker, but we can maybe improve on this. It's more continuous. There's a bit of a gap between that one and what I'm going to create is another one. I'm going to copy that text box that I've got. I'm going to click and drag with Control held down. I could do a Control C or a Control D right now to copy. So I'll get another text box with the same text, same format, same animation effects, which is very useful because this will be very similar. I'm going to set the duration as 10 seconds again, same duration, but I'm going to set a delay. This delay will be for 5 seconds because that is half of the duration. You would always set a delay for half of the duration. So if the duration was 14 seconds, that would be 7. Now I'm going to move that on top of the other text box. See, it nicely snaps in place when it's in the same position. That's good enough for our purposes. That is bang online. And then I'll play the slideshow again. And this is now what we have. It comes across. Seems a little bit quicker than it was before. And immediately the other one is coming across also. So now we have this continuous loop. With two text boxes rather than the one looping round there where there was a little bit of a kind of delay in between. I'm actually going to go back to my text boxes here. I'm going to use the animation pane on the right so I don't have to worry about moving that and moving it back again. And I'm actually going to, this is the first one, there's no delay, increase that to 14 seconds. And then the second one, increase it to 14 and increase the delay to 7 because it must be half. And you can test these out until your heart is content. I think that works better now, slowed down. It seemed a bit more hurried with the other box in play. And I think that's a nice kind of scrolling news ticker effect. For me right now, to really tease my audience into what's going to happen in this workshop, they'll continually be rolling while they gather and pick up their coffee, have a chat, eat a few biscuits until it is showtime and I press my slide button, that disappears and we're on to the action. I hope you found this video tutorial useful. Please check out some of my other video tutorials on a YouTube channel and come check us out at computergaga.com.